This game was interesting. The game and also anime had been on my radar for a while, but last year was when I finally played it, and it was quite a ride. The review is going to cover the first two Danganronpa games. I know there are others, but these two are the games that comprise the main story other than the Future and Despair anime arcs which I haven't seen, so this is where I'm making this review. The review is also going to be mainly spoiler-free, though I will have a spoiler section for the end, so if you don't want spoilers, you're good for now, just be ready to click off when I give you that warning later on. Both these games have a similar concept and structure. They're about a class of students at Hope's Peak Academy, the most prestigious school in the country. All of the students are ultimates at something. For example, the ultimate swimmer, ultimate programmer, or ultimate martial artist, or even weird things like ultimate clairvoyant. But when they think they're going to have a normal and fun school life, they discover that they are now trapped in the school, and the only way to get out is to murder one of the other students without being caught. Yes, this is a very happy and fun game. Gameplay-wise, you basically control the main character as he goes around, solves mysteries, and all that. The gameplay is rather basic most of the time. You just walk around, talk to people, and then investigate things throughout the school. The class trials are a bit more interesting, though we will talk about that later on. The story of the games are broken into chapters. The first part of each chapter has the characters investigating the school and trying to find a way out, or just try to learn more about what's going on. Then you have some free time where you can have the main character talk to the other students and get to know them better, which lets you learn more about the different side characters and even sort of develop relationships with them. Then after a few days of this, someone commits murder in an attempt to escape. Then the characters gather evidence and have a class trial where the characters have to figure out who the murderer is, otherwise the murderer goes free and everyone else is executed. Because Monokuma has a twisted view of justice. Who is Monokuma, you may ask? Well, that is a loaded question. But he is a fluffy teddy bear of doom and the main antagonist of the series. And let me just say, he is a wonderful villain. I love how twisted and evil he is. He's manipulated the other students to commit murder, pushing them to their limits for his own amusement. But as evil as he is, he's also quite playful in his twisted way, and he sticks to the rules of the game that he has created. Yes, he could easily kill all the students whenever he wants to, but that's not how he does things. Instead, he'll give the characters a push and let their evil take it from there. Really, the thing I like most about the game is how well it handles all the mysteries and the way it interleaves them. The mysteries involving the murderers are really great. During the investigation process, you come across all the evidence you need to piece together, though it's typically hard to see what all the pieces actually mean. And then during the class trial, the picture slowly comes together. But of course, there's always a twist, or multiple twists. That way, even if you figure something out or expect one twist, you won't expect the other, like, three surprises. There is also the greater mysteries of the school, too, though this is typically more the focus later on in the game. There is a big risk that when a story is built so much around the mysteries that when we finally get the answers, it will fall flat. But in this case, it ended up working out really well. Though I do feel the first game was a bit too vague with its answers, though this is resolved at least somewhat in the second game. And then there's still the Future and Despair arcs, which I think will fill in the remaining pieces. Hopefully. I want to go watch those, by the way. Another thing I like about this game is the lack of plot armor for the characters. The whole point of the game is the murder, which means the characters are going to die. And while sometimes you might be able to guess who the next victim is, it's more often than not a complete surprise. Like, there will be a character you'll probably think will be alive till the end, but turns out they're the first person to die. Or if you are like me, you will have your favorite two characters die in the same chapter. Yeah, that one hurt. It was probably my favorite chapter in the series, but it definitely hurt. Unfortunately, all the deaths sometimes leads to a character dying early on that you didn't really have a chance to get to know, so it lacks the impact. But even then, they don't feel like throwaway characters, which was good. And the cast as a whole was really good. They oftentimes started as some sort of stereotype based off what they were the ultimate of, but as the game went further along, they were more explored and fleshed out. The killing game definitely changes them as they are forced to see their friends kill each other. There was also some amazing voice acting which really nailed the emotions and all the different personalities. Though this leads to one of my annoyances with the game, and that is the fact that it has only a partial dub. The big scenes are all fully voiced, and voiced very well. But the more minor scenes, only the characters say something that sort of fits the actual text, but they aren't voiced in the lines. Hopefully that makes sense. If you played enough Japanese games, I'm sure you'll have come across this. And this is really jarring and breaks the immersion. I know this isn't the only game that does it, so you like Fire Emblem Fates, Persona 5, among others, but it still hurts the overall experiences, and that is definitely one of the reasons I did not care for Persona 5. The class trials could also be annoying at times. For the most part, I liked how they worked. The game led me along enough to put the pieces together, and it was fun being able to give the answer that showed the contradiction in what the characters were saying. Though there are times where I knew what the answer was, but could not figure out how to say it. Like, one part of the trials is the non-stop debates, where the characters will be talking, and you have to find a contradiction in what they are saying. And there are times where I would know what the contradiction is, what the game is wanting me to say, but I could not figure out the response that would basically say that that's what I'm saying or pointing out. Though, all things considered, this is a pretty minor complaint, and the trials are a great way to unravel the mysteries. So I hope you enjoyed listening to me talk about why I like Danganronpa, and you definitely should give this a try. You can get the two games as a bundle for like $30 or $40, and it is well worth the money. So if you've not played this yet, then I will see you next time. But for those of you who have played it before, let's talk a bit more. Spoiler time, by the way. I want to take this time to detail a couple of the more of the positives and negatives I have with the game. First, one of the good things is Junko. She was a great mastermind. She was completely off the walls in both games, and even managed to top Monokuma in Insanity. Which, considering she was controlling Monokuma, that makes sense. But still, she was good. And sadly, while I liked Junko, I did not like what they did with Mukuro. With her dying in the first chapter, we never really got to get to know her. Though you could talk to her some in the free time scenes, but those are just too easy to miss. And she seemed like a really interesting character. And there's the same thing with the ultimate imposter in the second game, though I think I may get more of him in the Despair arc, so I'm not going to complain too much here, though we'll see how that goes. I also want to talk about the second game because it really is just great. I loved how it took all the tropes established in the first game and twisted them. Like, you have the whole memory wiping thing which plays a role again, but in a different way that feels fresh while also being familiar. Then you have all the ideas of hope in the first game, but then you have Nagito in the second. Which, if you are wondering what chapter I was talking about where both of my favorite characters died, yeah, that was chapter 5 of the second game. Like, I loved Chiaki! She was so great! And Nagito was great in a completely different way. But yeah, sadly they both died. Though Nagito's plan was incredible. Like forcing a spy from the Future Foundation to kill him while making it look like a suicide, and all because he wanted to kill the Ultimate Despairs. Well, that's amazing. And another thing I like about the second game is how well they pulled off the whole computer simulation thing. The reason it worked well was that I did not expect it here. Like in the first game, I wondered, could it be computer simulation? Which it wasn't. So that made me just completely rule it out for the second when I shouldn't have done so. And you have so many things here that were really weird and would not make sense unless it was a simulation. So yeah, wonderful storytelling here as well. And another thing that stood out to me between the two games is how Monokuma is acting slightly differently. In the second game, Monokuma is being much more aggressive in getting the characters to murder each other. Like making them sick in Chapter 3, where Mikan regained her memories of being in Ultimate Despair, or taking their food away in Chapter 4. Monokuma is not playing fair here, but he doesn't need to. In the first game, he had to stick to the rules because he wanted to prove to the world that the characters would give in to despair. But here, in the second game, he doesn't care about that. He just wants to use the killing game to draw the future society into this world so that he could destroy them, or Junko could destroy them, or Junko's simulation could destroy him. So yeah, great game, and I plan to play and watch more of it before too long. So yeah, expect more Danganronpa content before too long. So thank you for watching, and I will see you all next time.